Hey guys, it's Alexis. Welcome back to my channel, and today I'm gonna be trying a wig, a human hair wig for the first time ever, and I'm very excited. Can we take a moment for the packaging first? Look how beautiful and cute this is. I got a wig from Wigshe, and it's a human hair lace front wig, and I'm really excited because wigs are kind of a bigger investment and they can be intimidating at first. If you are new to my channel, I discovered I had PCOS, which is polycystic ovarian syndrome, when I was about 16 years old. I am now 23 and have kind of been struggling with hair loss and hair thinning ever since then. I know my hair loss could be a lot worse, and some people might even look at me and think, you don't need a wig, you barely have any hair loss, you still have your hair. For me, my hair loss feels significant, and I've always been interested in trying a wig. Hair loss can be different for every person. It can make someone feel insecure no matter how significant the hair loss might be. For me personally, I am just not as confident with my natural hair. So I'm gonna show you how I put this wig on, what it looks like, and I also did not cut the lace off of it yet, so I have to do that and fit it to my head. So I'll show you and take you through the unboxing and what it looks like. So let's get into it. The wig comes in this little silk bag. So cute, the packaging. There's like some pink paper, and then they also come with this wig headband. I'm pretty sure it's to help grip the wig, and there's also this lace opening for your part so it looks more realistic. I personally like putting on the wig without this, but up to you. And then we're gonna open up the bag. I got a pre-curled one. So look how beautiful and great quality. It's so soft. You can see it has the full lace front here. And then it has clips on the inside, and then some at the back of the neck. And it also has this like adjustable thing that I think you can like snap together like that for it to be a little bit more secure in my head. But personally, it fits my head amazing and I don't even need any of the clips. So yeah, I got the wig 054. Got it in 16 inches because I want it to match my natural hair length so that I can wear my hair down underneath and just like blend it in. You could still like flatten your hair and put it back, but I feel like it would give me a little bit of a bump, and I just like it to sit at my length. I got 120% hair density, the lace front cap. I got the average cap size, and then lightly bleached knots. All of that. I will say the highlights on this wig look a little bit different than the image online. Highlights on the picture I chose, the highlights looked a little bit more blonde, whereas I feel like these are a little more darker, which is fine. I've never had highlights on my hair, so it's just like a nice little change. Just looks a little different than the picture, I will say. Wigshe was also nice enough to give me a coupon code to give to you guys, so it's going to be AlexisB10 for 10% off of your purchase, and I'll also link this exact wig that I got in the description. You can get it in different lengths and customize it to your head. But yeah, you can use the link down below if you're interested. Now I'm just gonna take my hair down and put on the wig and show you what it looks like. And I need to cut the lace, which I've never cut lace on a wig before, but I was watching videos and it doesn't look too difficult, hopefully. Okay, this is what she looks like on, and my natural hair is peeking down below here, and I'm gonna like curl it to like blend in a little bit better, but I feel like it's such a good length because it matches my hair. The curls are beautiful, it's so soft. The highlights I am like a little not used to just because I'm not used to having highlights, but if I put the hair behind my ear a little bit, I feel like that helps me a little bit more normal with it. And I like to pull out my like sideburn pieces here to help it blend a little bit better. But yeah, this is how it looks up close. I need to push my hair back a little bit more. This is crazy. Let me show you the bag a bit. Oh my god, I love it. It's like such a nice thickness. It's so pretty. I think my hair in the back might be a little longer than the wig, but now I want to cut the lace off so we can see what it looks like without it. I'm just gonna use these little baby scissors that I have and this mirror. I'm cutting it that way. Yeah, I might need to go sit at my desk to cut this. I'll be back. Okay, I'm back with the lace cut, and look how natural that looks. Like, wigs can be scary because you fear that it's gonna be so obvious, but I feel like this looks so natural, especially from far away. And obviously, like, not everyone's gonna be staring super closely, but even if they are, like, it looks so good and natural. And yeah, again, so I just have my like side pieces pulled out, and I curled my hair to like mold with the wig better, but I think it just looks so natural and pretty, and I'm so excited to wear this now. You can also style it, obviously, and curl it, straighten it, do what you want to do with it because it's human hair. But yeah, I got it pre-curled because I just like to not put heat on hair so that they last longer and the quality stays nice and soft. The lace was also extremely easy to cut. I just like went right around the hairline, and it doesn't have to be perfect because even if it's a little mismatchy, that like blends a bit better. But yeah, I definitely recommend Wigshe wigs. They're also very nicely priced for the quality of their wigs. I know wigs can range in the thousands sometimes, but most of their wigs are like in the 500, 600 range. So definitely a great price for the quality. And I hope this video was helpful. If you have any questions about this wig or how I put it in or anything, leave a comment down below and I will definitely answer them. But yeah, thank you so much for watching this video, and I'll see you next time.